The project I'm, well, the work we are presenting is the result of several projects funded here in Barcelona. I'm collaborating with some of them. I'm just speaking because I'm able to speak English, kind of, more or less. We'll present what we did. Now we are working on getting the data out of them, okay? So the general goals of the of these projects was to bring science, and in particular archaeology, to rural neighborhoods. You know that the city center in Barcelona can be a bit rural, and also people with social needs here in Barcelona. So we develop actions for all types of public, from children to elderly, older adults. And the main objective was to make inclusive activities for people that generally don't go to museums or don't engage with science or with archaeology. And in particular, people with disabilities and older adults and also newcomers. How we did it? Well, first, we engaged the participants in the activities. It wasn't just us speaking about something, they were part of it. We engaged also both public and private institutions because there are some collective working already with these groups of people, local charities or the city council. And then we built an interdisciplinary, well, one built, the interdisciplinary team with researchers and psychologists, social educators and also journalists. Why all this? This shouldn't be necessary, isn't it? But it is. Because although on the paper everybody has the right to have access to the physical, social, economic and cultural environment, and to health and education, in reality there are groups of people that don't have access, don't have really access to several things. And why is this? Because most scientific institutions, including universities and museums, when planning activities, they plan activities for children in school or for families, but in general is the medium class. It's not the for everybody, and especially not for people with special needs, because they need other things. So the result is that then people with special needs believe that science is not for them, because they don't engage with activity. And it's not because science is not interesting for them, it's just because the format of it is not suited. So here we are going to present three outreach projects specifically designed to involve people with different special needs. And this includes people with disabilities, mental disabilities especially, then older adults, and then newcomers. So this is how we conceive the approach. We are researchers, but then we are working with different people, and then also with the local political institutions and social institutions here. As I said, we can't provide you with data about the benefits of it, but we are going to focus on how we did it. And now we are working on the questionnaires to have the quantitative data. Okay, the first group are people with disabilities, with mental disabilities. We did several activities with them. One was an archaeological excavation. So young people with Down syndrome were actively participating in an excavation. Only the children were allowed to excavate, but the families were also there. And they all learned about archaeology and about a number of things because they worked with the archaeologists on the site. And it was amazing. It was an incredible experience for them. Not only for the children, but also for the families who work with them. The return was very, very good. And we were working with the Association for Down Syndrome here in Catalonia. So it was done in collaboration with them. And also with the University of Barcelona. Other activities included workshops for different people. So we did conferences about prehistory and food in the past. And the key thing here is that when speaking about the Neolithic, it wasn't just Neolithic at all. We needed to try to bring a timeline to explain, okay, we are here, and then it could go past, here is the Neolithic, and much older is the Paleolithic, because it's too, there are concepts too abstract, too difficult to understand, and to freeze time is difficult. So we brought a timeline, a hard timeline. So when speaking about lentils, we brought through lentils. When speaking about animals, we brought animal figurines, because you can speak about sheep or cattle, but it's much easier to have a cattle, a sheep, or a dinosaur and say, okay, this is much, much older, it's not a cure. Okay. So it was very sensorial. And then they prepared a prehistoric menu for the families and friends, and also they participated in a guided visit to a Neolithic mine, where you can enter into the mine and touch the, well, everything. The exposition is very sensitive, sensorial as well. The other group, and the second group, is the other older adults. Here the activity was to create a puppet show. And the interesting thing here is that the older people made the puppets, and they also did the theatrical performance. And Juan was leading them to create the argument of the theater, the same thing. The funny thing about it, or the nice thing about it, is that it created an intergenerational participation, because the older people were creating they were doing the puppet show, and then the public were children and lots of a diversity of public, because they did the show in libraries, in civic centers, school, senior residents, local festivities. So they were doing the show in different for different audiences. So it created this kind of thing of link between the older adults and all the rest of the participants, the attendants. Other activities included visits to museums and archaeological sites, explained by archaeologists, and then also conferences and comedy shows where archaeology topics were covered. And also this magician team, also with archaeological tricks. And the last group we are dealing with are newcomers. In this case, we were working with this cooperative in Busan, and this group of teenagers were following a prehistoric cooking course. It was a part of a diploma. In order to have work afterwards, like in kitchens. Okay. So first they attended conferences on prehistoric foods when we were engaging with them. Then they were cooking products, typically from history, and then they presented the cooked dishes to the researchers in our research center, and also their family and friends. The outcome of this is that it has been mentioned before, this sense of belonging, this sense that you are bringing something to society, to other colleagues or peers or family or... So again, the return was very positive. The feedback we got was very positive, and was like, okay, when are we going, when are we organizing the next? So we are now working towards building this questionnaire to have the hard data to prove people, listen, this is working, and this, we need more of these activities in the neighborhood. But little by little, we can see that our activities are starting to have an impact. This is the Christmas decoration in one of the civic centers here in Raval. So we are integrating with the social tissue here, and also with the Christmas decorations here in Barcelona. The lights that you can see there, the reality comes from a picture of three of the researchers at the SIC. It was a local initiative, it wasn't us, but we then participated and engaged with this. So if we want to be updated for the activities we are organizing, you can check this blog, or you can write to the Juan. It's very quiet, but he will answer. well, I would like to thank you for your attention and also to all the citizens.